pumped because I get to talk to my favorite Parks and Rec director and yours, Tim Hamm. Tim, this has been probably the craziest 3 months you've ever had to deal with in Parks and Rec. Would you agree?
I would. It's been very interesting, to say the least. You know, this all started, the COVID-19 pandemic, as we were finishing up youth baseball, softball registration, youth soccer registration, and getting ready for our season. We actually canceled the season, you know, like right at the last minute, basically the day before opening ceremonies. So that was very stressful for a lot of people. And it's just, you know, it's just kind of continued. We've tried to figure out, you know, what can we do, continue to do to halfway keep it normal for our residents, for our kids. You know, our parks have pretty much stayed open, our walking trails, and things like that, so people would have somewhere to come and just keep their mental peace about them. Because it can be very stressful, stuck in your home.
Absolutely.
And things like that. So we kind of phased in our parks. You know, our ball fields are open now. We're going to start up competitive tournament play the week of the 15th.
Okay.
You know, we've tried to continue with our registrations. We have youth football and cheerleading registration going on at the moment. We're not asking anybody to pay at this point. We want to just see who all wants to be involved in that. And once we get the go ahead, we'll go ahead and start processing payments for that. We start movies in the park this week. I think that's going to be big for the community. That gives us a chance to adhere to social distancing guidelines and still, you know, present something for the community to come out to the park and just hang out.
Yeah.
So that starts Friday the 12th. We'll be showing the new Lion King movie, which I've watched a million times with my daughters at home, and it's really good. So I do encourage everyone to come out this Friday around dusk. We'll try to get that started at Veterans Park in the back play meadow.
So will that be going on every week, every 2 weeks? How does that work?
That works out about once every 2 weeks.
Okay.
The teen council at some point will start doing those as well for the teens in our community.
Yes.
And that'll start, they're meeting now, trying to get that schedule lined up. But so we will start having those every other week as well, which
Good.
Is going to be big for a place for our teens to come out and hang out and get out of the house, so to speak.
Absolutely. In a safe way.
In a safe way. There you go. One thing I'd like to point out, our senior center has been hit pretty hard by this. You know, the demographic of the customers that we serve there are high risk. Our senior center staff's been great. They've continued to do meals for them. Cultivate Church has donated a lot of time, a lot of time with that and worked with Bertolone's and feed them a good hot meal from Bertolone's.
That's great. I had no idea about that.
Every so often. But our senior center staff's working hard, homebound meals and things like that, doing a lot of virtual classes, you know, virtual Zumba and things like that,
yeah.
which we've had a lot of participation in, and it's very exciting that our staff's able to still offer those things.
I know that's so hard for that staff, because we did a segment with them a few months back, and they have so much love for them. They love seeing them every day. It's such a social environment for them to come out. So I know that has been hard for
them. Yeah, and our center's one of the most busy in Shelby County. So that was a big undertaking for our staff to continue those operations as they have. And we don't know when our senior center will reopen. Like I said, that's one of the high-risk categories with all that's going on, and so the state's going to be giving some direction on that as we move forward.
Okay. You know, I think that's kind of going to be the theme for most things now, is it's an ever-changing situation. So when it comes to registration, when it comes to when payments are going to be due, and what everything is going to look like, it's kind of to be determined, right?
It is. You know, a few things that we're going to have moving forward. We're going ahead with adult kickball registration. That's going on now. This will be our second year with that program, and last year it was really good for a first year program. The people had a really good time with that. So I do encourage you to keep an eye on our website for updates on all of our registrations. As we move into July, we'll have youth baseball and softball and youth soccer registrations that will pick back up. But we'll be updating our website, sending out emails to our database, keeping everyone informed on what we can or can't do as we move forward and try to figure our way through this summer.
thank you guys. I know it's been a tough thing to navigate through. I know you guys are doing a great job, and we look forward to the future.
Oh, I do too. Thank you all for having me.